You're listening to Bodhi Light Tales, the podcast for mindful people on the go. Hello, this is Miao Guang. Today's Bodhi Light Tale is Fruit Portrait. Once upon a time, there lived a stay-at-home mother named Dorothy. She would take care of her children and family. Every day, she would prepare plates full of fruits for the whole family to enjoy. One day, her youngest son, George, had just come home from school. She greeted him when he came in and said to him, "There is a plate of fruits on the table in the living room. Help yourself to enjoy as many as you would like. I'm getting dinner ready right now, so I will join you when I'm done cooking." George went into the living room and saw the plate full of fruits. He began to get really excited and first picked up an apple. As he looked at the apple, an idea popped into his mind. He decided to draw a lady's face on the apple. When he had finished drawing on the apple, he then picked up a banana and drew an old woman's face on the banana. His gaze then fell upon an orange. And following suit, he picked up the orange and drew the face of a man. When Dorothy had finished cooking and came into the living room, she immediately noticed the faces on the fruits, and she was furious. She grabbed George's arm and, pulling him to her, began to thump him in anger. George cried and tried to run away from her, but his mother was so strong, he yelled, "Mommy, please stop hurting me. Why are you so angry? What have I done wrong?" Dorothy hissed angrily and replied, "What do you mean that you haven't done anything wrong? Look how bad-mannered you are. How many times have I told you not to play with your food? If you want to draw, that is what your drawing books are for. Why do you never listen to me when I talk to you? I told you to eat them, not spoil them with your silliness." George managed to release himself from his mother's grip and then ran to hide under the table. When he felt safe, he said quietly, "I just wanted to make sure that everyone had a piece of fruit. My sister likes apples, so I thought that if I drew her face on the apple, she would know that the apple was for her. Grandma loves bananas, so I drew her face on the banana. And since Dad likes oranges, I drew his face on the orange. If my drawings made you so angry, then I would never draw again." After hearing her son's explanation, Dorothy felt ashamed for having beaten her son. She said to him gently, "I'm so sorry, my son. Please forgive me. I misunderstood you. I didn't realize you just meant well and were being kind. Please come here." She then hugged him and begged him to forgive her. Dorothy felt so grateful and blessed to have a son like George. Not only was he a filial son, he was also caring and considerate. She realized she had drawn the wrong conclusion without thinking, without compassion. Her misunderstanding could have easily been avoided if she had only just stopped to ask why he had drawn on the fruits. How often do we get angry without asking why or to what end first? Would it not be better to reject anger and ask ourselves whatever is the reason behind the cause? In this story, Dorothy acted in aggravation without even asking herself or her son why he did the drawings on the fruits. She could have chosen not to scold her son. Throwing anger at children is not the way to teach them. It could easily affect their physical and mental development as well as leave scars that may last a lifetime and never fully heal. Just as Venerable Master Hsing Yun says, anger does not solve problems. Working hard to resolve a situation does. Anger is the result of an inflated ego whose fury, once extinguished, will transform into a mind of peace and calmness. Misunderstanding leads to trouble. Misbehavior leads to resentment. Dishonesty leads to disapproval. Confusion leads to disputes. Therefore, we must remind ourselves to stop and consider the intention of any action or thought before responding. We must learn to understand what, how, and why our children think the way they do. Simply by asking about their behaviors, the way they learn, and the choices they make. As we do this with them over time, we offer them our guidance and help them to understand themselves and others, as well as grow as a person. This is Miao Guang. Thank you for listening to Bodhi Light Tales. Subscribe to us and have stories delivered to you every week. May your day be filled with happiness and wisdom.